Excuse me, Mr. DJ. Can you please play my daddy's record?
You'll always be wars to conquer, he's so self-plunder. I am what you made me, a motherfucking monster. Wars to conquer, resources to plunder. I am what you made me, a motherfucking monster. Wars to conquer, resources to plunder. I am what you made me, a motherfucking monster. Wars to conquer, resources to plunder. I am what you made me, a motherfucking monster. Wars to conquer, resources to plunder. Cannabis, Vinne Paz.
Solitude in a life of a ripper is quite bitter. I ain't no social network nigga, fuck Twitter. If I can't be lyrical, I get miserable. You don't want me to be miserable, so let me go. Or detain me, entertain me, talk to me frankly. This is how you thank me, I'm one of the good guys, thankfully. Good equals evil, how can it be? How can it be? See, I am exactly the way I was made. Even when I change, lyrical content still bangs. Can't wait to hear what you spit over this. The beat flatline, I rhyme Jedi Mind tricks. Vinne Paz, hand the fist, philanthropist. Pass the cannabis for the assist. I hold my breath, then I burn the shit down. From the ground to the roof, all ground troops against one cannabis nuke. Next time you regroup, bring a chemical suit. Cause I don't wanna get vegetable soup puke on my boots. The way that interpermeates time will flatline. Radially, we will be inside that line. Jedi Mind 30. I will identify the force that binds. Force of the rhymes, eternal solar signs. Sunspots, bitten sunshine. Wow, like Busta Rhymes. Give me the track, if I touch it, it's mine. Duct tape you to the table, hook you up to the jumper cables. Remember what I told you about Azazel. Worlds to conquer, resources to plunder. I am what you made me, a motherfucking monster.
Well, check this out. It ain't never righteous to lie on your brother, man.
That's what you are. And that's what you'll always be.
You know what I'm saying? Tell the truth.
Kill me.
If it got something to do with me and you,
come on.
You gonna add out to the world. Tell the truth, man. I came up to the studio to discuss the track, how we was gonna do it. You told me you was getting 80 G's a track from Christina Aguilera. You did 7 tracks, you was hyped, you was all cheesing and smiling. You was happy about it. You charged me 40 G's for the track we was gonna do. Eloise cut you the check, sent you your first half, scheduled studio time. I came up to D&D, dirty ass D&D. First day, you was an hour late. Second day, you was 2 hours late. Third day, you was 3 hours late. The fourth day, you was 4 hours late. Come on, man, tell the truth. When I stepped to your ass, you, yo, tomorrow you gonna be 5 hours late tomorrow? Yo, my bad, bitch. I had to move my mother out of the house. So I said, alright, just call, man. Just call, let me know that you're doing something, you're busy, so I don't have to wait for you, you know? So I ain't gotta wait in the studio. I had shit to do. Everybody got shit to do around 5 o'clock in the evening. So come on now. I don't know what it is, man. Niggas bringing up some shit 14 years ago, like that shit is current news, like it's important now. What's important now? How is that important? Look how many times we worked together since then, or how many times I've seen you since then. And then everybody wanna know what's wrong with the culture. You know what I'm saying? Come on, man, it's not a good look. How does that help anybody in the situation except you? How does it help me? For you to be out there saying that I'm difficult to work with, how does that help me? How does it help you? You kick dirt on me, that helps you though, right? Make you feel better, right? Come on now, tell the truth. You was late to the studio like you didn't take it serious, like it wasn't important to you. You shovel shit on me like I wasn't 100% professional in working with you. Like I didn't come through to the sessions and wait for 10 hours. I work with DR Period on Salute. Everything was dope. Ask DR Period how our studio session was and how I was professional. Ask Fly Top how I was professional. I had to go to Rakim's crib 5 times before he did the record. But he did it. And the days before the day that he vocaled, we was just building and I enjoyed it. Why you don't speak on that? Speak on the shit that's good for hip-hop. good for you and good for me. Why shovel shit on me? For no reason. Who you working for? What agenda do you have? How are you helping hip hop by doing that? I do my best on every track. I go hard on every record. But you wanna go on TV and radio and what have you and say, yeah, cannabis was this and cannabis was that. For no reason. 14 years ago. Why you don't talk about what we did on Sea of Tranquility? Come on now, tell the truth. Every album, I do the best that I can do. The best that circumstances will admit me at that time. Nobody's perfect, but goddamn it if I don't give it everything though. 100, at all times. And it's as if there's some sort of a movement or some sort of deliberate attempt to always, when it comes to cannabis, it's always bringing up old shit, something from 14, 15 years ago. Always old shit. Never what's currently coming out of cannabis' catalog, what he's doing currently. And it's like a deliberate attempt by the media and everybody who got a motherfucking microphone in their hand in 5 minutes to do a little video bite to talk about old shit when my name come up. Always coming up somewhere. It's always coming up. And to combat that pressure, niggas is talking about old shit instead of talking about what most recently came out. Talk about the Magic album and what was being said on that album. Talk about Sea of Tranquility and the topics and subject matter touched on that. Talk about something that's relevant to now. Don't bring up some old shit that ain't got nothing to do with nothing. Come on now, you know what you're doing. I ran that baton for so far, man. You ain't supposed to never say something foul about your kid, man. How does that help you? The irony about it is that you smiling talking about it. But it's bad for me, but you smiling though. And then when I get a little bit tight about it and say something about it, everybody look at me like I'm out of pocket. And I'm out of bounds. You the one that's smiling, lying. You already knew. And when I say, alright, nah, man, yo, tell the truth. Tell the truth what happened. Tell them niggas, man. You was the one that was late to studio. Every day, you was late. Come on now, tell the motherfucking truth, man. Tell the truth. It's like you didn't want to do the record. Everything about you and your body language is telling me you didn't want to do the record.